Yeah, so I'm telling you, like, I gotta get them fries in.
Is that
Can't wait to see your stories, man. I'm waiting.
Who are you talking to?
Oh, talking to Gio from JFD.
Gio from JFD, what stores I do on Thursday? Who is this?
Gio from JFD.
What are you editing, Gio from JFD?
Stories.
Where they sound boring.
Weekly episodes every Friday. Like a good news channel, JFD TV's there.
Good morning, Longhorns. I'm Itzel Romero, and welcome back to JFD TV for Friday, March 1st. For this week's top story, here's reporter Vivian Nguyen with a look into this year's Hall of Honor.
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we will honor four alumni and one faculty member. Let us begin the induction ceremony of this prestigious 2024 Class of J. Frank Dobie High School Hall of Honor. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we begin with the class of 1981, Mr. Mike Spencer.
How does it feel to be back here at Dobie?
It's amazing. I actually was back here last year. My very best friend I grew up with, Sammy, he's right there. He was inducted last year, and so, but Dobie is, it's always going to be my home, always.
Next, ladies and gentlemen, if you would, please welcome from the class of 1982, Miss Laurie Baker.
When I first got the call from Miss Calderer, I was so stunned because, for one, I didn't even know that I had been nominated, and then to have the opportunity to be representing my class and being recognized for some of the things I've done.
From the class of 1993, please welcome Miss Michelle Manzanales.
It's such an honor and pleasure and so much fun to be back at Dobie. So I graduated a long time ago in 1993, before you were probably born, right? And so it's just a lot of fun and it's a great honor.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the class of 2003, please welcome Mr. Devon Fanfare.
I was the last graduating class of the old Dobie, but I did spend a summer helping build or helping put the furniture in the new Dobie, so it feels great. You know, you have all those memories that come back to you.
Next, ladies and gentlemen, if you would, please welcome to the stage former faculty member of J. Frank Dobie High School, Miss Ann Brannan.
I love Dobie. It is the most rewarding time of my career. I love Dobie.
This plaque is more than just a recognition. It's an inspiring reminder for all those who pass by this wall to strive forward in life and take risk instead of playing it safe. Let yours stand tall among our grades. You have earned this honor today.
How's your night going?
Oh my God, I'm blown away. This has been not only a special honor, but just seeing so many old friends and familiar faces. And I gotta tell you, everything they did tonight just made all of us feel incredibly special. And, you know, there's a lot of people that I graduated with and have graduated from this school that have amazing stories. So I just feel very fortunate that I had this opportunity.
My night went excellent. This is amazing. This is amazing. And to do it in my alma mater, like, college was fun, but this, Dobie is my life. If you cut me, it will definitely be orange.
It was great. It was so nice to be here at Dobie with all of the other inductees and like with old friends that came to see it, old faculty members that I hadn't seen in forever. So it was really, really great experience.
Oh, incredible. A little choked up from all of the love and appreciation, and it was really great to see my family and coaches and teachers, and it was good.
So this has been just so overwhelming and heartwarming, and I'm so excited that I got to do this, and I thank everybody that worked on it, and my students were such a joy to me. I got more out of them than they got from me.
You know, it's always a beautiful ceremony. One of my favorite nights ever of all my time at Dobie is getting to come to the Hall of Honor, getting to see the inductees honored and hear their great stories, and then also getting to see kids receive scholarships for future, you know, things that they're going for in their life. So it's so super night. Everybody's so happy, smiles on all faces.
it was an amazing event, honoring all of the great Adobe alums as well as Miss Brennan. It was such an honor to be a part of it.
I think it went great. Don't you think it's cool that past students come and get to walk the school again and see all their friends again? And then we get to see, like, oh, they are former Longhorns. It's pretty cool to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all very much for attending. Enjoy the reception. Good night. Go Horns.
Here's reporter Jeremy Casares with a look into this year's Hall of Honor scholarship winners.
How did you feel about receiving the scholarship?
I just feel really blessed and so grateful for this opportunity and to be a part of like a group of like talented recipients as well as just like a dream come true. And I'm so grateful for this opportunity.
I felt really blessed to receive the scholarship because I really didn't think that I would get it, because I remember doing the papers, but when I submitted it, I waited for a long time and I was like, did I receive it? But then right when I thought about it, they called me down and they were like, you received the scholarship. So I felt really blessed because I prayed for the scholarship. So I just want to thank God for letting me get this scholarship.
I'm very honored to receive it. All my hard work in high school has paid off, all the late nights and all the overnighters, and I'm really thankful to all my friends and my educators who've helped me get there, and I wouldn't be there without this school and everyone who's helped me, so I'm very honored.
I feel very appreciative of all the people who have supported me, because I have lots of friends and family members and teachers too who have always been there for me when I'm going through tough times, and for them to be like a bed of support while in order to get, like, allow me to get the scholarship. I'm so thankful.
Congratulations to all the scholarship winners. I'm Jeremy Casares reporting for JFD TV.
Key Club had a game night this past Tuesday. Here's reporter Ollie Gomez. Now, here's sport.
I'm Hermione Taylor, and your Longhorn Sports Report starts now. Girls soccer play earlier this week. Here's reporter Alana Gorey with the story.
What are some things y'all working on to finish off the season?
Staying more consistent, working on finishing like on our goals, and just communicating more on the field.
Yes. How are y'all preparing for playoffs?
Working on things we need to improve on and setting goals for ourselves.
sure to keep supporting our girls as the season ends. Reporting for JFDTV, I'm Alana Gorey.
During our recent boys soccer game, reporter Alina Morgan was able to catch all the action.
How'd the game go?
Overall, it was a really good game. We followed the game plan the whole way. We took revenge on Channelview. Like, they had beat us 2-0 in the first game. When, yeah, it was a really good game. It feels great to like have beat them.
What's your favorite part of the season so far?
My favorite part of the season was when we went to Austin. We got a good time over there, and we all did good over there too. That we all had fun and everything, and that's about it.
Soccer boys a lot of luck on the rest of their season. Reporting for JFDTV, I'm Alina Morgan.
Baseball had a tough game against Clear Falls. Here's reporter Paris Cervantes with the highlights.
How has your season been so far?
So the season's been doing pretty good. We played some pretty good teams in Laredo and yesterday against Clear Falls and scrimmages, everything. But we've been doing good. Everybody's been on a roll, you know, getting started. We got a lot more coming.
What has the team been doing to prepare for this season?
We've been practicing real hard, you know, every day, Saturdays, just working everything we can, taking every rep seriously, always putting the work. I practice, outside of practice, everything, so just that.
Thank you. Okay. How has your season been so far?
My season's been pretty good. I've been seeing the ball pretty well and hitting the ball hard. And I'd say my defense's been pretty good and solid.
What has the team been doing to prepare for this season?
We've been hitting a lot, getting a lot of reps in on our offense since we've lacked a little bit of hitting, but you know, we're getting better and we're locking in and we're starting to see the ball well, way more better from the start of the season, and we're seeing the ball a lot better and hitting the ball harder.
We'll bring you more baseball action as the season continues. Reporting for JFDTV, I'm Paris Cervantes.
With an early season update on softball, here's sports director Amaya Cotton.
Thank you.
How do you think the season is going so far?
It's not bad, but we're gonna get better eventually in the season.
It's going pretty good, but we do need to fix some of our mistakes and bounce back. So, pretty good.
What is the goals for this season?
To tie being district champs.
I think our goals this year is to stop being the underdogs because we're kind of young. So it's just like, they don't really expect much. So just try to be great, be better. To at least tie with Deer Park, and that's about it.
Make sure to wish our Lady Longhorns good luck on the rest of their season. Reporting for JFDTV, I'm Amaya Cotton.
The Lairds competed the past 2 weekends and came home with many awards. From the Ascension Dance competition 2 weeks ago, they left with multiple first and second place awards, as well as grand champion runner-up team. This past weekend at the American Dance and Drill Team competition, the team and officers won gold best overall for their dances. Lizette Gonzalez was awarded fourth runner-up for her solo, and Freda Monreal was awarded second runner-up for her solo. That'll do it for your Longhorn Sports Report. Back to Itzel in the studio.
Thanks, Hermione. Now with more updates from College Now, here's reporter Alexa Gonzalez.
If you are planning to attend Texas A&M University at College Station or Texas A&M University at Galveston, then this announcement is for you. You are eligible for a chance to win $1,500 in scholarship. Be sure to scan the QR code for your chance to win the Bay Area A&M Club Scholarship. The application is due March 31st. Class of 2024 seniors, submit your college acceptance letter and any scholarships you have received to Portable 16. Your scholarship will be listed in the graduation program. Also, if you have enlisted in any military branch, make sure you let Ms. Lozano know as well. Seniors, this is very important. A FAFSA application is required in order to graduate. After you've completed your application, you will get an email from the U.S. Department of Education. Make sure you forward the email to Ms. Lozano by April 15th. Also, on March 4th, between 6:30 and 11 a.m., enjoy coffee and donuts while you and your parent complete the FAFSA application in Portable 16. If you are interested in the San Jac Promise Program, head over to Portable 16 to make sure you are up to date with registration requirements. On March 2nd, the Historically Black College and University will hold their annual fair. Make sure you register before you attend. You can scan the QR code or go to www.hhbcuaa.org. Reporting for JFTTV, I'm Alexa Gonzalez.
That's all for this week's show. To watch past episodes, look for us on SchoolTube and YouTube. To keep up with the latest here at Adobe, follow us on Twitter and Instagram at JFD_TV. Have an amazing weekend, and we'll see you back here next week.